Hello, welcome to my home. By now you will have heard Schumann's beautiful Kinderszenen, and as you can gather from the program, this is a recital program based on childhood and innocence. Now, I wanted to pair the Schumann Kinderszenen with the Chick Corea children's songs because I consider Chick Corea to have been one of the greatest musical geniuses of at least this last century. The way that he was able to navigate through the jazz idiom, but at the same time, somehow keep a foot within contemporary music language, and the mixture of the two, I find incredibly appealing, exciting, and I just love to play his children's songs. Even though they are miniatures, you can see how within them there is a complexity and there is somehow something very novel in the way that he chooses his harmonies and the way that he, where he takes us. So I hope you enjoy these pieces, and I would like to dedicate this performance to the memory of Chick Corea, who will always remain as one of the greatest musicians of all time.
Thank you. Thank you.
What I'm going to play next are my own childhood memories. Now, I've played this program many, many times in the last year and a half, 2 years, before the world stopped. And my idea with my childhood memories was that there would never be even one note written or even a tonality chosen or anything at all. But each performance would be a very fresh and spontaneous recollection for me of these specific memories. Now, the first one is the sense that I had as a child of waking up in Caracas, which is it's where I'm from, and it's a urban jungle, which somehow the juxtaposition of this humongous concrete maze that is Caracas, together with the overwhelming, powerful nature that surrounds it, the mountain of El Ávila, and the flora and the animals that somehow inhabit this crazy city, it's something that's always struck me, how somehow nature always imposes itself. And the first improvisation will be based on that. It's also written in the program notes, more or less an impression of what I remember. Now, there is nothing written, musically speaking. These are pieces that happen now and don't happen again. The second one is about the parrots, the huge guacamayas, which are it's like a macaw, huge parrot. And these parrots just fly around the whole city and land, sometimes six or seven of them on your balcony. And they're beautiful creatures. So there's a huge diversity of birds, and specifically these parrots I always remember. And just, again, the city and the wildness living together. Now, the third one is this about a little, a very, very thin, frail, old man, someone who didn't have a home, who would walk up and down the street of where I lived in Caracas with a little boombox on his shoulder. And just that impression of this drunk man who would just kind of stumble, and you know, you would always hear his little music, salsa, playing in the background. And just my memory as a child of this funny, you know, quirky man who was just always on the street. The next one will be missing home, which is something that I carry with me everywhere I go. It's part of who I am now, as it is for millions and millions of Venezuelans. And for those of us who are living abroad, and the 5 million refugees of Venezuelans that now exist around the world, the sense of having lost our home is something that is a permanent scar that we carry, and it's a permanent pain that we have learned to deal with, yet it always surfaces. And when I improvise on missing home, this well of sadness and impotence and frustration and just the sense of having lost where you're from just takes over and creates something that is always very, very, very moving and very tragic. And the last improvisation, it's my mother's lullaby. Now, my mother doesn't sing, she never sang, but it is a Venezuelan custom that mothers sing to their children to put them to sleep. And I don't remember a specific song. I mean, she used to sing to me the national anthem of Venezuela and many, many lullabies to put me to sleep, but it's not that I'm remembering any particular melody. I'm just going back to that feeling of being in her arms, or feeling loved and safe, and the tenderness of a mother's love. And this is what I evoke in this improvisation. Now, as I said, this set of childhood pieces will never happen again. It's just for you. I recorded all of this in my home. And what's wonderful about them is that they're impermanent. And they always bring me back to these memories, to very specific memories. So these are my childhood pieces. Thank you. Now, after I recorded the Schumann and the Chick Corea and my own childhood pieces, I decided to just continue at the piano and just improvise something. I've already heard it, and what came out is, again, something that was not planned, where there is no structure, there's absolutely nothing that exists except that I sit down at the piano and then the faucet opens. That's kind of how I describe it. And I hope you enjoy it. It is a once, you know, in a lifetime rendition of a piece that doesn't exist. And like every improvisation that I do, it comes from a place that is a mystery. It's very interesting neurologically what happens when I improvise, but that I will leave for a possible documentary that will happen at some point. And all I can tell you is that when I improvise, I get out of the way and I connect to something that is very primal, it's very emotional, and it's very childlike, because my imagination at the piano is something that even I don't understand, yet it's always there. It's that inner child that remains a part of me and will always be there as long as I'm creative. So I hope you enjoyed the concert, and take care and be safe, everyone.